Hey guys, so today's video is going to be part two of my Europe and USA haul, and today is all about makeup. I have this whole box here filled with makeup. I ended up going a little bit crazy just as I wanted to pick up a few things that aren't really available here in Australia, and also I was planning on picking up a little bit of my wedding makeup as well, which I actually didn't really grab everything I wanted. I figured I'd probably wait until a couple months before the wedding, which is sort of now, but maybe in a month's time I might pick up a few more bits and pieces that I was looking for. But I'm gonna get started in order of what I picked up, and so we'll go back to Italy. And while I was in Italy, I discovered Kiko, and I'd actually heard about this brand before from a few other YouTubers, and I really wanted to check it out. So I popped in and I actually ended up grabbing a few things that I really loved from Kiko, and I want to try a few more of their products. But the first thing that I grabbed were a couple of their Kiss Balms. These are just tinted lip balms. I actually grabbed a third one, which is coconut, I think, and it's just a clear gloss, which is somewhere in my bag. I can't exactly find it, but these are quite kind of slippery. They sit on the lips. I don't personally find these very moisturizing, so I probably wouldn't have picked up three had I known that, but they are a little bit of fun, and I think the packaging is super pretty as well. It's this gorgeous metallic, and the coconut one is sort of a gold color, so they will definitely look very pretty on my vanity. Then I needed a new eyeliner, as somehow while we were traveling, my Maybelline liquid eyeliner actually dried out. So I grabbed the Kiko Ultimate Pen Longwear Eyeliner. This has actually become my eyeliner of choice. So it's just a pen eyeliner, pretty standard, but I just find that I manage to get a perfect wing every single time I use this, so I will definitely be trying to purchase some from their online store so that I can stock up a little bit. Finally, the last thing that I grabbed from Kiko was an eyebrow mascara. This is just a brown eyebrow fibers colored mascara, it says on here. I quite like this, as it sort of is currently replacing my need to grab a brow wiz from Anastasia, but this is just been doing the job, and it's not too warm tone, not too cool tone, so it sort of sits somewhere in the middle. When we're in a pharmacy in Italy, while I was trying to find something to ease my mosquito bites, as I mentioned in my Italy vlog, I am allergic to mosquitoes. I just have really bad reactions and my legs swell up if I get bitten on my legs. I found that they have the Marvis toothpaste. This is the weirdest thing to be showing you guys, but this is the whitening mint, and the reason why I grabbed this is because I love the Marvis toothpaste. They have a whole bunch of different flavors, but they are so expensive. I think in New Zealand, grabbing a tube of this is something like $20. However, in Italy, it's about €3. So I kind of wish I'd stocked up, and I only actually grabbed the one. So looking forward to using that, as it is really nice and fresh and minty. Then heading over to the US, this is where I actually purchased the bulk of the makeup. And my first stop was the drugstore. I popped into Duane Reade, and I kind of hate that actually they put these stickers on everything that you purchase, and I can't really seem to get the stickers off. So if you know how, please let me know. But I'm gonna start with eyeshadows. That's probably one of my favorite things and one of the things I was most excited about. I grabbed this Wet n Wild Studio Eyeshadow Palette. Now this has, how many eyeshadows are in here? 10 eyeshadows in here, I believe. There's a really good selection from, there's a couple of mattes, the black, the brown, and then this taupey shade, and then the rest are shimmers. And I found that this is really, really pigmented, and it's actually a great option for every day. Being able to wear this to the office, I mean, you could actually wear this taupe all over the eyelid if you really wanted, so being really impressed with this. I actually really love Wet n Wild. It's one of my favorite drugstore brands, and one that I always have a really positive experience with. Then, speaking of eyeshadows, I also picked one up from NYC. NYC is a brand that I'm not really that fussed with, but I just thought this looked really cute. It has a highlighter, an all-over lid shade, and then a crease shade, although, funnily enough, these are all shimmers, and I wouldn't really wear shimmers in the crease just because I don't really like that look. I tend to prefer a matte. This is the Treo eyeshadow in Central Park Plums. And I just really like the fact that it's sort of more pinky, mauvey tone. Those are the sorts of eyeshadows that I tend to go towards, and I just thought that this was a really cute little trio to have in my makeup kit. While I'm not a huge fan of powder highlights, I'd seen a lot of British vloggers raving about L'Oreal's True Matte Lumi Powder Glow Illuminator. So I thought, since I saw it while I was there, I would pick it up and give it a go. And I have to say, again, this has not made me love powder highlighters. I do think it is a really nice powder highlight, particularly for the price. It actually comes with a little brush underneath, which I didn't discover until yesterday. But I tend to just use a small eyeshadow blending brush or some sort of fluffy brush to apply highlighter to my face if it's a powder one. But I really like the fact that this has a few different colors in it. The only issue for me is the fact that there are a lot of glitters in here, so you can sort of see the glitter on your skin, and that is something that I personally don't like very much. Okay, so the next product I want to talk about is from Rimmel, and it is their Match Perfection Skin Tone Adapting Concealer, and I got this in the shade 125 Fair. Now, I had heard people talk about this, say it was amazing, so I thought it would be a really great alternative to the Rimmel Wake Me Up Concealer, which I really like. Didn't like this at all. It's actually got a really interesting applicator. It's sort of like a brush. It reminds me a little bit of the YSL Touche Éclat, except this you actually have to squeeze to get the product out. I find that this ends up looking really cakey on my skin. I really just don't like the way that it sets. So this isn't something that I would purchase again. I'll probably use it up, but maybe if I powder a little bit more. I did powder and it still looked cakey, so maybe I'm just using this wrong. If you've got any tips, please let me know. Then I also picked up a few lipsticks, and I grabbed a couple from Milani because I really like their matte lipsticks. So I got the shade Matte Flirty, which is a really pretty burgundy red, like a deep red, which I thought would be beautiful in the wintertime, which it is here in Sydney now. And then I also grabbed Matte Blissful, which is sort of a purple toned pink. I think this is really pretty, and I wore this while I was in LA and I loved it. I just think it's such a great springtime shade. Then I also grabbed from Wet n Wild, you guys, I said I really love Wet n Wild, and I actually love these lipsticks. These are their does it say on here? Doesn't actually say, but the shade of this is Just Peachy, and let me actually open it up. But yeah, it's just a really pretty nudie peachy shade, which I thought would be perfect for spring. I really love it. The only thing I hate about these lipsticks is the packaging, because the lipstick sticks out from the bullet, and when you pop the lid on, sometimes it actually ends up scraping the side of the lid and it just gets very messy. But aside from that, these are probably one of my favorite drugstore lipsticks, and I find that they last on your lips all day. You don't really need to top them up at all, so I highly recommend. I'll pop a link to this and actually everything I mentioned down below just in case you would like to check it out. Now, I don't know whether I talk about MAC or Sephora next. I might talk about MAC. If you were watching my vlog, and I will pop a card up here somewhere for you guys to check it out, I went into MAC and I wanted to build my own MAC eyeshadow palette. I actually have so many MAC eyeshadows, it's borderline ridiculous. I've got the Nordstrom and MAC eyeshadow palette, which was a Nordstrom exclusive, which I really love. That's a 15 pan palette. Then I've also got 2 4 pan palettes, which I made up myself last time I was in New York. And I think I filled both of those up. So I've got quite a lot of eyeshadow, particularly since I actually filled up a 15 pan palette while I was in New York this trip as well. So this is the eyeshadow palette. I actually have on my phone all of the eyeshadows that I purchased, but I went for very sort of peachy, pinky, beigey tones. I wanted something that was going to be really easy for me to reach for on an everyday basis. There's a really great mix of mattes, satin, and shimmery finishes, but I should be able to, hold on, I've got my phone down here, go through all the eyeshadows that I picked up. Okay, so on the bottom row here, I've got Retrospect, Grain, Arena, Soft Brown, and Patina. Or maybe it's the other way around. I think it might be that way. Then this one here, I've got Wedge, Naked Lunch, Girly, Mythology, and Tempting. And then this next row, I've got Sumptuous Olive, Sable, Espresso, Cranberry, and Sketch. So I thought this was just a really great set of eyeshadows to round up my collection. And it was funny because when I was talking to the girl in MAC, she said to me that I pretty much have every single eyeshadow from MAC now, just based on all of the previous shades that I already had in my collection. So if you guys would like to see a full eyeshadow collection from MAC, like swatching and everything like that, and I'll just talk about all the shades, let me know in the comments down below, as I'd be happy to film something like that. I just really adore MAC eyeshadows. Truthfully, I haven't used this yet. I have been wanting to keep it really perfect, but I think I might crack into it this week. It's just now opening it up from pulling it out of the box again, I am so excited about this palette and it's just sort of everything that I have been really wanting. So very, very pleased with this. And actually, just a side note, the reason why I wanted to grab this while I was in New York is because MAC is so much cheaper in America. So in order to build a 15 pan palette here in Australia, it costs us about $350 Australian, somewhere around there, because I actually calculated a while back when I was planning on building one here. In the US, it probably costs you around $130 US, which is what, 170 Australian, so it's less than half the price to make it in America, which is why I kind of went for it and bought so many eyeshadows. While I was in MAC, I also decided to grab a lipstick because there was a shade that I had been wanting to grab for a while, and it is Lady Danger, and it's actually what I've got on my lips today. Looks like that, or I mean, you can see it on my lips, but I love this. It's sort of a, it's more of a neutral, but it's got a slight orange undertone to it, and it is the matte formula, which I love. It's super creamy and easy to wear, and definitely unlike a lot of other matte lipsticks that I've tried. Oh, wait, I actually grabbed one more thing while I was in MAC. I completely forgot. I grabbed a full-size bottle of their Fix Plus. I use this every single morning when I am doing my makeup, and I'm putting a little bit on my beauty blender that I use to put my foundation on, and I just love this. And I also think it's a great sort of priming mist, or also something to spritz on your face after you've applied all of your makeup. My last stop was Sephora, or kind of. And one of the things I really wanted to try when I was at Sephora was the Urban Decay Naked Skin Foundation. This is the Weightless Ultra Definition Liquid Makeup. So this is peptide infused, light diffusing, and paraben free. And I'd heard really great things about this, and I thought that this could be a really good option for wedding day. I grabbed it in the shade 30, and I think this is about right for me. Maybe it's a little bit light because I did get a bit of a tan while I was on holiday, but I really like the formula of this. It's got a pump, which makes it super easy to apply, and it's quite a thin consistency. It's very weightless, as it sort of says on the packaging, and I just really like the look of it on my skin, so this has definitely been a winner for me. Then while I was at the counter, they had all these really adorable minis, and I couldn't help myself. So from Urban Decay, I also grabbed the concealer, the Naked Skin concealer, which I'd heard great things about as well. And I have to say, because I haven't tried the NARS creamy concealer that they have, but I love this. I'm obsessed. It is really creamy and lightweight and liquidy at the same time. I got it in the shade light neutral, but just how cute is this? It's so little. I love it. It's super cute and great to have in your purse if you need it for touch-ups or anything like that. Then a couple other things that I grabbed. I grabbed a mini of the Balm's Porefessional. I wanted to try this out and I do really like it. It's sort of got that silicone-y feel, which for me, as I do have an oilier skin type, I find to be the best type of primer for my skin. So really, really pleased with that. And I'll probably end up buying the full size at some point. Then I grabbed an eyeliner, and I really wanted to try one of these kinds of eyeliners. This is just Sephora own brand, and it is the High Precision Eyeliner in black. Now, unfortunately, I actually found this really easy to apply my eyeliner. It's got a little brush, and I've never used that type of eyeliner before, but unfortunately this is just not waterproof, and my eyes tend to weep quite a bit, and it was really windy, so my eyes started watering, and then all of a sudden I just had this big black mess in the corner of my eyes. So I will not be wearing this again, and I don't really know what to do with it now. So really unfortunate, as it is super black and it applies really nicely. So that was a bit of a shame, bit of a letdown. From Sephora's own brand, I also grabbed one of their cream lip stains. I got this in the shade 07. I can't remember what the shade name is because they don't actually leave them on the bottom, but this is a really pretty medium toned pink. It's sort of got a slight blue undertone. That is what it looks like. I really like it, and I got really good compliments when I wore this. Then I just want to rush through the end because I know I bought so much. I also got from Urban Decay the De-Slick Makeup Setting Spray. This is the oil control version. I thought that this would be great for wedding day. I have never used a setting spray before, so that's what the bottle looks like. I've heard this is meant to be quite good. Maybe I will try it on my face right now. This is probably a bad idea, but Well, it feels really nice on my skin. I don't know if it's gonna make my makeup last any longer, but I will report back. I know a lot of people swear by this, so I'm sure it is really good. Then I grabbed a mini from Origins. This is the Clear Improvement Active Charcoal Mask to Clear Pores. This sounded really interesting to me and I thought it'd be a really great product to pick up, as I just sort of feel like when you're traveling, your skin really starts to fight against you, and because you're going in planes, it gets really dry, and also sometimes you might be drinking a little bit more than you usually would, or eating bad food or whatever, because you're on holiday, so why not? So I thought this would be really great for when we got home. I actually haven't tried it yet, but I love anything with charcoal in it, so I'm sure I'm going to really like this. Then I grabbed a lipstick from Marc Jacobs, and this is the shade Sonic Truth, and it is a really light nudie mauve shade. It's very, very pretty. However, the formula, what's that one there? The formula is very different to the other Marc Jacobs lipstick that I have, which I love. This tends to sit a little bit more on the lips. It's a lot creamier. I'm not sure if I've got really pigmented lips, but it's the type that if it starts to wear from the inside, it'll look like you haven't applied your lipstick properly. So it doesn't really adhere to the lips the way that I like lipsticks too. So that was a bit of a disappointing one, particularly because Marc Jacobs lipsticks are super expensive, but I'm sure I will end up using it regardless. Then I've just got two more products to talk about. The first is another eyeshadow palette. I really went ham on the eyeshadow. This is from Urban Decay, and this is the Gwen Stefani palette. And I've been wanting this for ages. It's about, I want to say $90 here. And when I saw it in America, I saw it in Macy's and they had it for $25, which is just insane. It was less than half price, and I figured it was a sign that I had to buy it while I was there. Why not? So I have really been enjoying using this. The eyeshadows themselves are super pigmented. They blend out really beautifully. I think there are so many great shadows in here for everyday wear as well. And also just have a bit of fun at night. I love the fact that there's this blue and this pink, and I think this gold here is just stunning. I can't wait to use that and just have a play around with this palette a little bit more. So very impressed. And the matte shadows are incredibly pigmented, which I think is always a really good indicator of how good a quality the palette or the eyeshadows in the palette are going to be. Then when I was in the airport, I grabbed one more thing, and this was from Herbivore, and it is the Sea Mist Coconut and Sea Salt Beach Wave Hair Mist. You're supposed to spray this in your hair when your hair is damp, and then it's supposed to give you sort of beachy waves. I've tried this a few times. It doesn't do anything for me, and I'm not sure, am I not spraying enough in my hair, or is it just not that good? I'm not sure. Can you guys let me know in the comments below if you have tried this or if you tried anything from this brand? I was sort of sold by the packaging. That was kind of why I picked it up. It's very minimal. And I really like the typography, which is sort of why I gravitated towards it. Plus it was only $12, so I figured can't really go wrong. If it's bad, it doesn't matter. It's only $12. But I'm really disappointed in this so far, but maybe I just need to continue to give it a go. So let me know what you guys think. But that was all of the makeup that I picked up while I was on holiday. I definitely went a little bit crazy, and I was saying to Luke, it's a little bit embarrassing how much makeup I did buy, but I hope you guys enjoyed watching this. You got some ideas maybe for things that you want to try out yourself. Let me know if there are any brands of makeup that you highly recommend, or like any particular products that you'd recommend for all day wear. So really would appreciate any of your recommendations. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time with a brand new video. Bye.